Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial, Linear Algebra, Unit Number 3, Linear Transformations. Let us see the definition of vector space homomorphism. Vector space homomorphism. Let us take capital U of F and V of F be any two vector spaces defined over the same field capital F. U of F and V of F be any two vector spaces defined over the same field capital F, and F is a mapping from U of F into V of F. F is any function. F is a function from U of F into V of F. Then this F is said to be homomorphism if it satisfies two conditions. The first one, F of alpha plus beta is equals to F of alpha plus F of beta, and the second one, F of A alpha is equals to F of A alpha is equals to A into F of alpha for all alpha comma beta belongs to U and A belongs to the field F. I repeat the definition. Observe that U of F and V of F be any two vector spaces defined over the same field capital F. F is any function from U of F into V of F. This function F is called homomorphism from the vector space U of F into the vector space V of F if it satisfies two properties. First one, F of A alpha plus beta is equals to F of alpha plus F of beta, and the second one, F of A alpha is equals to A into F of alpha for all alpha comma beta belongs to U and A belongs to F. So observe that if the same mapping F is onto also, it means it is a homomorphism and onto. It is a homomorphism and onto. Then it is known as epimorphism. If the same homomorphism is 1-1, then it is known as monomorphism. If it is both 1-1 and homomorphism, then it is known as isomorphism. Remember that fact from ring theory. A homomorphism, which is 1-1, a homomorphism which is 1-1 is known as monomorphism. A homomorphism which is 1-1 is known as monomorphism. Monomorphism. And the next one, a homomorphism which is onto. A homomorphism which is onto. A homomorphism which is onto is known as epimorphism. Is known as epimorphism. A homomorphism which is both 1-1 and onto. A homomorphism which is both 1-1 and onto. Which is both 1-1 and onto is known as isomorphism. Is known as isomorphism. Remember these basic definitions. Isomorphism means a homomorphism which is both 1-1 and onto. Monomorphism means a homomorphism which is 1-1. Epimorphism means a homomorphism which is onto. Remember these basic definitions. Next, we define very very important definition which is known as linear transformation of vector spaces. The next important definition, linear transformation. To define linear transformation, we need two vector spaces. Let us take U of F and V of F be two vector spaces, be two vector spaces defined over the same field, capital F. U of F and V of F be two vector spaces defined over the same field capital F. A mapping or a function or a transformation all are equivalent words. A mapping or a function or a transformation capital T that maps from U of F into V of F is called A linear transformation is called a linear transformation is called a linear transformation from U of F onto V of F if it satisfies the condition T of A alpha plus B beta is equals to A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta for all alpha comma beta belongs to U and A comma B belongs to the field capital F. Observe that. U of F and V of F be any two vector spaces over the same field capital F. And a mapping, the same word is also known as function. It is also known as transformation. A mapping or a function or a transformation, capital T, that maps from U of F into V of F is called a linear transformation if it satisfies the condition T of A alpha plus B beta is equals to A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta for all alpha comma beta belongs to U and A comma B belongs to capital F. In the previous definition, we learned that homomorphism of vector spaces. In that definition, we learned two conditions. F of alpha plus beta is equals to F of alpha plus F of beta. And the second condition is F of A alpha is equals to A into F of alpha. The combined condition of these two conditions, F of alpha plus beta is equals to F of alpha plus F of beta, F of A alpha is equals to A into F of alpha. The combined condition of these two equations or these two properties is that T of A alpha plus B beta is equals to A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta. So this is known as combined condition of these two properties. So anyway, this is very, very important definition. Learn this one. So U of F and V of F be any two vector spaces defined over the same field capital F and any transformation T maps U of F into V of F is called linear transformation if it satisfies the condition T of A alpha plus B beta is equals to A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta for all alpha comma beta belongs to U and A comma B belongs to capital F. So let us see some examples for this linear transformation. And we see the basic examples, which is known as zero transformation and which is known as identity transformation. So let us see the first one example. Let us take U of F and V of F be any two vector spaces. Capital T is any mapping U of F into V of F defined by T of alpha is equals to 0 bar for all alpha belongs to U. T of alpha is equals to 0 bar for all alpha belongs to U. Now take any two elements alpha comma beta belongs to U of F. Let us take alpha comma beta belongs to U of F. By the definition of T, you have T of alpha is equals to 0 bar, T of beta also equivalent to 0 bar. Since alpha comma beta belongs to U of F, then for any two scalars, A comma B belongs to capital F implies A alpha comma B beta belongs to U of F by applying the scalar multiplication property. U of F is a vector space. So every vector space satisfies the scalar multiplication property. U of F is a vector space. Every vector space satisfies the scalar multiplication property. Therefore, A alpha comma B beta belongs to U of F. This is nothing but A alpha plus B beta also belongs to U of F by applying closure axiom under addition. So by the definition of T of alpha is equals to 0 bar for all alpha belongs to U. Instead of alpha, we have A alpha plus B beta. So which implies T of A alpha plus B beta is also equivalent to 0 bar. Is also equivalent to 0 bar. Further, now calculate this value. A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta. T of alpha is 0 bar, T of beta is also 0 bar, which is equals to A into 0 bar plus B into 0 bar. This is nothing but 0 bar. Therefore, A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta is equals to 0 bar. Now you observe the conditions. T of A alpha plus B beta is equals to 0 bar. And A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta is also equivalent to 0 bar. Combining these two conditions, we get T of A alpha plus B beta is equals to A into T of alpha plus b into t of beta for all alpha comma beta belongs to u. This one t is known as a linear transformation. So any mapping defined in this way, t of t maps u of f into v of f defined by t of alpha is equals to 0 bar for all alpha belongs to u, is a linear transformation. Is a linear transformation. This linear transformation is known as zero transformation. This linear transformation is known as zero transformation. Let us define in a similar manner, in another way. Example number 2, u of f and v of f are any two vector spaces. T maps u of f into v of f defined by t of alpha is equals to alpha for all alpha belongs to u. Now you observe that t of alpha is equals to alpha for all alpha belongs to u. Here take the codomain also u of f. T maps u of f into u of f. T maps u of f into u of f. The domain and codomain is same. So now you observe that, let us check that this function is a linear transformation or not. Let us take alpha comma beta belongs to u. For any two scalars a comma b belongs to f, by applying scalar multiplication property, a alpha comma b beta belongs to u. By applying closure axiom under addition, a alpha plus b beta belongs to u. By applying the definition of t, t of alpha is equals to alpha. If you substitute alpha, you get result also alpha. So t of a alpha plus b beta is equals to, you get a alpha plus b beta. What is a alpha? A into t of alpha. What is b beta? B into t of beta. Therefore, we conclude that t of a alpha plus b beta is equals to a into t of alpha plus b into t of beta for all alpha comma beta belongs to u of f. Therefore, t is a linear transformation. Capital T is a linear transformation. This linear transformation is known as identity transformation. This linear transformation is known as identity linear transformation. You observe that. So here in this, the same